ladies and gentlemen. Ron Wallace here with Balling Down South with another episode of the interview. My next guest definitely is no stranger to high school basketball. He's a head coach for the girls varsity basketball team. He has over 400 wins on his belt, 14 years in a row been won their area championship, 5-time Final Four appearances, 2 AHSAA championship appearances. And in 2019-20, they made it up to Montgomery to the semifinals. He's been coaching 19 seasons, going into his 20th season. Let me go ahead and introduce you to Davidson's head basketball coach for the girl about varsity basketball, Charlie Shipp. How you doing today, Coach?
Doing great, man.
Pretty good, man. I know we had some technical difficulties getting you on here, but we got you on here now. So, gotcha. So how's everything going over there at Davidson High School dealing with this COVID situation right about now?
It's going fine. We only have 12 in the program, and most of the girls are coming, getting their workouts in.
Well, I can tell you, looking at your resume, Coach, I'm sorry, Coach, you wasn't finished. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
All right, I was going to correct you. We won 17 in a row. Area Ooh. Championships. I'll hit 500. I've got, I think 492 wins right now.
Oh, wow. You almost in that 500 club, but man, that is good, man. That's an awesome resume. So for the people that don't know you, talk a little bit about yourself from, you know, when you are possibly in school and when you got your first coaching job.
Hey, well, I started out at private school at St. Paul's coaching varsity football, and I was coaching baseball, basketball, every JV and freshman sport out there. I went to Grand Bay to become the head football coach, and I was there the last 2 years it was a school. When they merged with Alba, I came to Davidson to help out with the football team.
Wow.
Then they needed somebody to coach basketball, so they told me I could do it needed somebody for a year, and that's been years.
Wow, that's a lot of coaching. So you not only have you been coaching basketball, you've done football, and you've done quite a other few things. So now getting the job at Davidson, you've been there for quite some time now, and I'm assuming you've always coached the girls basketball. Why did you choose to coach girls?
They needed somebody. It was the former coach had to step down she was giving birth to a child, and they needed somebody to fill the spot.
Well, need somebody to fill that spot. Wow. So now, Coach, now when kids come out to try out for your team, what exactly do you look for in a kid, you know, if you know you want them to make your squad?
All they have to be is coachable and love basketball. Last year we didn't have any seniors last year, and we were playing games on the varsity level with 7. TV would play a bunch of games with just 5 out. And so the numbers right now, we have 12 in the program. Hopefully I can find enough for a JV team this year.
I got you. Well, last season you guys 17-11, 8-2 in the region. You guys made it to Montgomery to the semifinals. What did it take to get your young ladies there to Montgomery?
Just to believe in herself. We had 4 returning starters to start the season. 1 transferred to another school, and 1 quit mid-season, and the other one didn't get eligible till second semester. So we pretty much had to rely on Kelsey to play with 4 newcomers every game.
Right, wow, 4 newcomers. So dealing with the pandemic, back on that, what are some of the policies and guidelines that you guys have put in place over there at Davidson High School, you know, getting some information from the state, what they want you guys to do, but what have you guys put in place?
Well, yeah, there's only certain times you can be on campus. It's broken down to sports, you know, inside volleyball goes in the morning, boys basketball goes at noon, and we go at 3 o'clock. And there's, you know, once your practice is over, you have to vacate the school. And like I say, we kids bring their mask. We wash the balls after each practice and make sure there's plenty of hand sanitizer for the girls.
Wow. Well, talk about some of the kids you got coming back, you know, to your program for this upcoming season.
Well, you know, starts around with Kelsey Thompson. She's been playing with me since seventh grade. She was first team All-State in the area tournament, the semifinal game. She hit 30 points against Baker. Two nights later, she hit 34 against Theodore to win the area championship. She was also most valuable player in the area tournament. You know, with all new players, basically she had to do a lot of the scoring. I feel that we have one of the top rebounders in Ayana Johnson. She's going in 11th grade. She can go get the rebound. Dinesha McCall, she's been running point guard. So, like I said, we've got I've got Christal Marlin. She'll be a sophomore. She set out last year. So, like I say, right now we have a couple injured. Hopefully they'll be with us in the fall.
Well, going back to your star player, Kelsey Thompson, you know, she got offers from South Alabama, UAB, Jacksonville State, got a lot of interest from a lot of other big Division I schools, Belmont, Auburn, Alabama, North Florida, Chattanooga, and Mississippi State. Coaching a player with such talent that she has, how are you able, you know, to keep her humble and you know, making sure she get a lesson in the classroom and comes out, you know, and practice and try to be a leader for your team?
Well, her freshman year, we stayed on her. She struggled academically. And then her sophomore year, she made straight A's. I was proud of her for getting in the classroom and doing the work. She comes to practice and works hard every day. Like I say, she's our leader, team captain. Like I say, she loves basketball. And, I look forward to seeing her at the next level.
Well, I can tell you this, man. You know, looking at her on this video, she can shoot the three. She can drive it inside. She can facilitate the pass. What else do you think she might need to, you know, improve in her game?
Oh, she's obviously she's our leading scorer, but she's also our leading rebounder. The job she did in the area tournament, you know, we beat a good Theodore team. Theodore had five girls. They're going to the next level, and they beat us twice during the regular season. And she did it defensively, offensively. She just she got after them.
Well, I know one of your nemesis teams you guys always play against, McGill Tulane. You know, with Coach Carla Berry over there. How is it? You know, you guys have to play them every season. Of course, you know they're moving down to 6A now, but. Do you guys plan on having them on the schedule at all this upcoming season?
Yeah, we'll all McGill. It's a rivalry. Ever since the 60s, Davidson and McGill basketball has been playing each other.
That's good.
For a good run, we dominated for a while, but lately McGill's been getting us.
Well, you got a few players. You know, you get those players off that injured list. I'm very sure you'll have those ladies primed and ready to go against, you know, pretty much anybody. Who are some of the other schools that's on your upcoming schedule?
Well, we have to get past Baker. They have a senior Latin team this year. They played us tough every game last year. Kelsey averaged 30 points a game when she played against them last year in three games. Theodore's going to be tough. And Coach Bridget, Mary Montgomery, he does a great job. Bryant, I think they have a first-year coach, and they're rebuilding. That's our area.
That's your area. I got you. Any teams you may play in the holiday tournaments, anything like that, if you get your teams together, are you guys planning on doing anything like that?
Yeah, we're traveling up to Huntsville, to Hazel Green. For years, we always went to wherever Coach Miller was coaching at. When he was at Bob Jones, we went there. He's at Hazel Green. We try to make a trip up there to play the Huntsville and Birmingham schools. So we'll start the season at Hazel Green. And then we always go to Mississippi. We always play some quality teams in Mississippi. We'll play Moss Point. They finished second in the state last year. Biloxi, they have a good squad every year. So we'll play our tournaments in Mississippi and North Alabama. And hopefully we're working on a local tournament in Mobile.
Gotcha. Now, Coach, with all the teams that, you know, you've had in the past, being able to get, you know, to the state playoffs, get into the Final Fours and stuff of that nature, what does it take, you know, going in, you know, to have a team of such caliber to be able to get to that level? What are some of the things you got to have in order to make that?
First of all, the girls have to get along. That's the biggest point. I've gone to last time I went to state, I had a point guard and a post player, and everybody else just did a great job of role playing. I've had some really good teams over the years. You know, we took 7 to the state finals 1 year. That was when Bendoff was a freshman.
Wow. Well, if you could talk to a kid that's going into their senior year, their last year of playing high school basketball, and they're getting ready to go off to college to play at that next level, what would you tell those kids?
Basically, college is a different ball game. You know, you have to. Everybody's good. You know, if you're not coachable, you won't last at the next level. I've had plenty of good players that, you know, didn't make it to the next level just because didn't want to work or things like that. They have other distractions. The ones that make it are the ones that stay focused.
Well, I can tell you this. I mean, you know, definitely got to keep these kids focused. Any of your other kids getting any interest from any, you know, college coaches?
Right now they're not, because we were so young. They were all sophomores last year. But I think this season we'll get I definitely got some girls that can go to the JUCO.
All right. I can tell you this. We know the COVID has pretty much got the sports world on lockdown right now. I know everybody's playing everything ear by ear. Definitely the basketball season definitely fast approaching. I know football is in the air right about now. Everybody want to get out there on that grid. But anything you want to say, that anything you guys got going on over at Davidson, anything new coming up this upcoming school term, anything of that nature?
I'm ready to go back to school. hopefully, you know, it's hard to locate which students come to Davidson. They go to several different middle schools, and, you know, I usually don't know who's coming until first day of school. And that makes it tough, because we get players from Phillips, Burns, Denton. We get them from all over, and it's hard to locate them.
Now, do you or your staff get an opportunity to go over and watch some of the middle school kids that are getting ready to come over to the high school?
Last year, I had two players that played at Denton, and I was at most of their games I could make and watch them play. They had to come up and play varsity with me last year.
Wow.
So I expect them to play varsity this year.
Well, Coach, I know you've been coaching for quite some time. You've been around the sports world quite some time, so I know you got a lot of knowledge inside of you that you definitely can give out to those kids, and all they got to do is just be willing to listen and be coachable. I know a lot of college coaches look at a lot of kids. Long as they're coachable, they could pretty much try to work with them.
Oh, yeah.
Well, everybody, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Davidson High School Girls Varsity Basketball Coach Charlie Shipp. Thanks for coming on the network today, Coach.
Thanks for having me.
All right, Coach.